type 2 diabetes is indeed fully reversible, and it is certainly a curable condition. A few years ago, I was diagnosed with an acute case of type 2 diabetes. My hemoglobin A1c level was at 11, an extremely high level. Normal is between 4 to 5.8. The physician looking over my test results said, "I have contracted a condition that has no cure," and spent a couple of minutes explaining the basics of the recommended diet, which is about cutting out carbs and eliminating sugars. He also put me on a very typical drug called metformin that later I learned through my own research that it was a wrong move by him. The very first time I took that drug, I realized it's not for me. I hated how it made me feel. So I cut up the pills into quarters and took just one quarter of a tablet a day with my meal for a little while. Then I noticed that even that small an amount was making me gain weight. Weight gain is the last thing you want when you're trying to reverse type 2. I didn't bother with prescription drugs after that point. I went to another physician who, just like a recorded message, repeated the same phrase heard by tens of millions of type 2 sufferers, that I have contracted a condition that has no cure. He was also going to suggest metformin, which I rejected, so he wrote a prescription for another drug that I never filled. The business of diabetes. The key point the second physician didn't bother to notice was that just by changing my diet and being more active and taking basically no prescription drugs, I was able to lower my A1C by a substantial level. Right then, I understood that there is something very, very wrong with how diabetes is being handled in the US, perhaps throughout the world. It's being used as a market for putting people on a lifetime of needless prescription purchases. So I started an intense research and self-education about how to beat this. The first rule of war is to know your enemy. Extensive research. For me, proper research means digging well beneath the mainstream and reading a variety of thoughts and solutions before forming an idea. One of the ideas that popped up early on was surprising to me, due to my own programming by the mainstream healthcare, that type 2 diabetes is indeed fully reversible and it is certainly a curable condition. The other point that hit home with me was that typically new patients should never be put on drugs and must be given a chance to improve their health first. Radical thoughts, but they are totally spot on, as my case proves it. I had one thing going for me. I was fit, but I was relying too much on carbs. And after a couple of years of combating type 2 and not beating it, I am even more fit. My A1C is at a mid-normal level of 4.9. In fact, I'm the best shape I've been since my 20s when I was an intense yogi. How did I beat diabetes? 1. Believing that it can be reversed. My research was extensive, and for me the results were concrete that this condition is 100% treatable, so I fully believed in the outcome. 2. Diet adjustment. By just trying to be healthy, I was already on very low processed sugars anyway. But I cut out all sugars whatsoever. I eliminated all baked goods, including all breads. I lowered my carb intake to the absolute minimum, and also eliminated all what I call white carbs, such as white rice and white pasta. Wasn't a fan of sodas to begin with, but totally eliminated all beverages with sugar and all juices. Juices are sugar concentrate. I snack only on minimal amount of fresh fruits, such as blueberries. Also apples with their skin intact. Simple veggies like raw carrots and nuts. 3. Daily exercise. I started a daily exercise cardio, light weight training and stretching routine. Initially began at around 10 minutes. Now it's up to 45 minutes every single morning. That's 7 days a week. 4. Sleep cure. Getting enough sleep every night is very important for self-healing. A good night's sleep is highly underrated. It allows your body to try to heal itself. I made sure to get enough sleep. 5. natural supplement. I also, on occasion, took a natural supplement called chromium picolinate. I am not sure how helpful this supplement was with my recovery, but it gets very good reviews online. 6. Total commitment. The key point to learn about beating type 2 is that it takes total commitment. Drugs or insulin injections will not cure you. In fact, the longer you take such drugs, the less effective they become. Hence, larger doses are required. Just to make a point about how committed I was and still am in beating type 2 diabetes, I haven't had white rice or pasta, any sugary drinks or candy, juices, baked goods, packaged goods such as potato or corn chips, desserts, or foods with thick sauces for a few years. The only baked products I do have is lightweight, no sugar added whole grain crackers. Obviously, meat products have no effect on your blood sugar. However, all generic meats, eggs, and dairy are filled with antibiotics and growth hormones and are extremely hurtful to your system. They also make you gain weight, and weight gain is the key culprit in becoming diabetic. Try to eat organic meats and dairy as much as possible. That includes products from animals that are raised humanely with no hormones and no antibiotics. Look for these labels: grass-fed beef, pasture-raised eggs, cage-free organic chickens, hormone-free dairy, etc. You could see weight loss in as quickly as 2 weeks. If you switch your diet from eating generic meats, high carbs, food with added sugars, sugary drinks, and meals with thick sauces to healthier choices. Rumi's the doctor joke. One of my short poems of Rumi, also known as Quatrains, that consistently receives huge laughs and roaring applause from the audience is the doctor joke. The doctor joke is from my book, Hush, Don't Say Anything to God, Passionate Poems of Rumi. I sipped some of love's sweet wine, and now I am ill. My body aches, my fever is high. They called in the doctor, and he said, drink this tea. Okay, time to drink this tea, he said, take these pills. Okay, time to take these pills, the doctor said, and get rid of the sweet wine of love's lips. Okay, time to get rid of the doctor. I never really understood why the audience in my events would react so excitedly to this poem, since I've always been healthy and have had little interaction with the mainstream medical system until I went through this experience. I hope this article inspires all of you to take a more personal and direct interest in your health and continue to educate yourself about ways to maintain your well-being through natural means, diet adjustment, some daily movement such as walking, and portion control. Trust in yourself and trust in your ability that you can beat this.